All righty, that was a great question, and now it's time for our second caller. Hello?
Hi.
Hi, who's this?
Helena.
Helena, okay, and you've got a problem for me to do?
Yep.
Okay, great. Helena, what grade are you in?
I'm in sixth.
Sixth grade, all right. Okay, so what's your math problem?
3 squared times 2 plus 4.
3 squared times 2 plus 4?
Yep.
Did your teacher write it this way, with the dot for the multiplication?
Yeah.
Okay, great. So for some people out there who may not realize, the dot means times, okay? So this is going to be 3 squared times 2 plus 4. So any idea where we're going to start with this thing?
Well, I think I start with 3 squared.
Okay. Now, do you know why you're going to start with 3 squared?
Because in PEMDAS.
Okay. So you're saying PEMDAS to me. Okay. And I'm going to write that down.
Okay.
Can you just review for anybody else there who's like, I've never heard of that. What does that stand for? What does the P stand for?
P stands for parentheses.
Okay, I'm just going to put the little symbol there. What does the E stand for?
Exponents.
For exponents, okay. How about the M?
Multiplication.
The D?
Division.
Okay, the addition. I gave it away. The A is addition, and how about the S?
Subtraction.
Subtraction, great. And so it stands for all those things, but what do those things mean? So what? Parentheses, exponents, multiplication, division. So what?
Well, they tell you what order you got to go in.
Right, and you know, mathematicians all over the world follow this order. It's not something we just made up here in New York State. It's all over the world. Everybody's going to follow these orders, okay? So you're going to do which one first?
I'm going to do exponents.
Okay, but just going back here, you always do parentheses first and then exponents. And these two are kind of weird. What's so unique about multiplication and division?
Well, whatever one comes first in the number sentence, you do.
Right. Some kids think multiplication comes first because in PEMDAS it's first. But if multiplication comes first, you do that. And if division comes first, you do that. And then the same thing with addition and subtraction, right? And what you mean comes first is you read the problem from left to right the same way that you read it. So it sounds like you know your order of operations. So let's take a look at it. We said we had no parentheses. And sometimes I like to teach my students GEMDAS with a G, so it's groupings. Not just parentheses, like absolute value signs. As well. Any parentheses up here?
Nope.
Or groupings? No. So you're going to say, like you said before, we're going to start with the exponents. So we have 3 squared. What does that mean, 3 squared?
Well, I think it means 3 times 2.
Oh, okay. So I'm going to write it down over here. So 3 squared. Little note on the side here. So 3 squared, if it was 3 times 2, I would just say 3 times 2, right? So there must be doing something different. So when we talk about 3 squared, you're going to take the number and you're going to multiply it by itself 2 times. So 3 squared is the same thing as 3 times 3, okay?
Oh, okay.
So what do you think 4 squared would be? That would be the same thing as 4 times 4. 4, right. And 5 squared would be?
5 times 5.
You got it, okay? And if we remember, if we want to multiply 2, we'd multiply it by 2. So we've got 3 squared. So you said we're going to do this one first, and you say 3 squared is 3 times 3. What is 3 times 3?
It's 9.
Awesome. Okay. So the next thing that we're going to do is we're just going to bring everything else down. You okay with that?
Yeah.
We're going to bring down the 9, we're going to bring down the 2, and we're going to bring down the plus, and we're going to bring down the 4. All right, so we had no parentheses. Are there any more exponents in our problem?
Nope.
How about multiplication or division? Any of that going on?
There's multiplication.
There is multiplication. And where is that?
9 times 2.
9 times 2. So we're going to do this piece next, okay?
Yeah.
I'm not doing it because it's first. It's because the order of operations tell me to do multiplication and division. And what is 9 times 2?
18.
Great. So 9 times 2 is the same thing as 18. And then I'm going to bring down the plus, and I'm going to drop down the 4. Any more multiplication and division?
Nope.
No? Any addition and subtraction?
Addition.
We have addition. So we're going to do 18 plus 4. And what is 18 plus 4?
22.
22. And look, we have no more operations to do. We have no more order of operations. So you know that you are done. And the answer to this problem is?
22.
22. You did a great job. That was a good problem. Thanks for calling.
Thank you.
Good night.